Hey guys, thank you for checking out my channel, and today I'm going to show you how to start making your own factory using Factory.io. So Factory.io is basically a simulator for automating your own factory. It's like Rollercoaster Tycoon, but then you need to program it. So first of all, you have to download it, and I have a link in the description where you can find it and download the program. So let's start it up. Okay, for this program you can open some existing scenes. It's like these, but we are going to build our own. So that's the most fun part. So we click on new, and now we have our own factory hall. And this thing we can build up how we want, and we're going to start with a small conveyor, a box and a sensor, just to learn how it all works. So on your right on the screen you can see all the products you can use. These are sensors and actuators and every kind of stuff. But we are going to use a conveyor, 4 or 6 or 2 meter, it doesn't matter. I'm going to use 4 meter conveyor. Then we put a box on it, right here at the beginning. That's not the beginning, here. Okay, so we want the box, the conveyor to turn on, so the box goes over the conveyor. Right now we press play, but nothing happens, so we need to program it, and for that we're going to use Factory.io's own PLC simulator. And to open that we click on file, drivers, right here, none, and Control.io. Okay, so first of all we're going to look for the tags. Now our conveyor is called Roller Conveyor 4M1. We can call it, we can rename it how we like, but it doesn't need in this situation. So we're going to drag it inside here. Okay? So now you see it's turned off. If we do press play, still nothing happens. Okay. We want to turn the conveyor on, and for that we're going to use a source and a bool, and that bool we can turn on and off, so we can connect it, and right now we can turn on the conveyor. If we press play, we can turn on and the conveyor starts to roll, and the box will go to the other side, but it will fall off and we don't want that, so we're going to add a sensor, and we're going to use this sensor. It's a diffuse sensor and it works very well with the box. Let's zoom in a bit, and we place it right at the end of the conveyor. You can place it how you want, you can turn, rotate it how you want, so this is good for this situation. So we open our app again, we're going to remove this one, we're not going to use it anymore. So now we're going back to our text, and we see now the diffuse sensor. So we drag that to the same place. Okay, so this diffuse sensor, we can connect it with the conveyor. If we do it like this, there is nothing going to happen because it's turned off. The sensor standard is off, and once there's someone, some box in front of it, it turns off. So we just want, when the sensor is off, to the conveyor one needs to be on. So for that we need a function block. I'm going to remove this one. We need a function block, and it's called logical at not. It will just turn the signal around, so 0 will be 1 and 1 becomes 0. So we connect it. Now we connect that. And now you see the conveyor starts to roll and it will stop at the sensor. And that's what we want. So that was our first project. You can see it again at right here. You can see it's high here, low here. And once it's in front of the sensor, this one is high and this one is low, so the conveyor stops. So, and then you're done with your first project. I hope you liked it. And in the next episode, we're going to do some more sensors and some more things, more actuators or sensors to work with, because there are a lot and we can make a very nice factory. Like you saw in the intro. So thank you for watching, and I see you on the next episode.